Hey everyone, this is Michael Manna and welcome to the T4 show. And I'm speaking kind of quietly because it's very early in the morning after my workout, and I wanted to give my impression so far on the Rhythm Plus heart rate monitor from Scosche, or Scosche, however you pronounce it. Used it yesterday with a DDP yoga workout, used it this morning with a regular cardio workout on the elliptical, as well as my weight training, and I want to give you my impressions. First and foremost, I like where it's placed. I've used chest strap heart rate monitors where they're kind of going away, and more so with this, and even the smartwatches that are coming out like the Apple iWatch are supposed to really do heart rate monitoring at a new level. But the chest strap is still the safest way to go. But with this, this takes it a step further where you don't need the watch like with Polar. This works over Bluetooth Low Energy, and I synced it up to my iPhone 6 Plus, which that's another story for a little bit later in the video. And once I got it paired, worked great. The thing I've noticed with a lot of Bluetooth Low Energy devices, especially these heart rate monitors, there's sometimes a 5 to 10 second delay, 5 to 10 seconds. So with DDP Yoga, it's fine because I just hold the position a little bit longer, count a little bit longer to keep myself in that zone 2, 3, and even sometimes zone 4 heart rate zones. But you don't get discouraged if you're working out and doing cardio and you're going about a minute or so in and you're still around in the warm-up zone. You have to really kind of work into it and then take into account that there is a delay with that. So just extend your workout and work out a little bit longer doing cardio, DDP yoga, or any type of activity. Now, the fit on this is very nice. This is the larger of the two bands. It's very comfortable. It is IP67 certified, so water, dust resistant, sweat proof, all that stuff. So you can actually take it in the pool, I think up to 1 meter. Don't go scuba diving with it or snorkeling, but if you're going to swim, it actually does work, and I'll try and test that out as well. One thing to note too about the pairing, I'm going to skip that out real quick. I tried to pair it at least 15 or 20 times. I used my iPhone 6 Plus, iPhone 5C, iPhone 5, Android phones, and would not pair at all. Reached out to Scosche or Scosche on Twitter, trying to see if I can get a resolution. The DDP Yoga community stepped forward and gave me some feedback on this, and it worked pretty good for them. I don't know if it was the DigiFit iCardio app, which once it synced up, it works great. I mean, once it paired up, it worked great. But it took about as long to pair as it did for me to do the DDP Yoga workout. And one thing that really, really bothered me was I reached out to them on Twitter. They saw the conversation going on, and about 1 a.m., 12 a.m., 1 a.m. my time, where I put out the tweet around 3:30 p.m. my time, they answer Lenny Backen, who said it worked great for him, with a general thank you to all three of us, me, Lenny, and DDP Yoga. So I understand, I work for technology companies, and I understand about the celebration and doing all that stuff, but when you have a customer that's really kind of, at that point, I was kind of my wit's end. I was like, hey, I kind of give up. They didn't reach out to me, they didn't reply or say, hey, DM us. Even places like AT&T, where they get a lot of flack, anytime I've tweeted them with an issue, they've told me to DM them, and right away, it's resolved. So now that it's paired and it's working, I'm pretty satisfied with the product so far, but I'm really big on customer support. I'm really big on the companies reaching out to customers. And I always thought Twitter, and I did a video a long, long time ago about how Twitter is the new way to really engage customers, solve customer service issues in a really fast, timely fashion, rather than calling, rather than the email tickets, stuff like that. And this is the first time in a long time, probably ever, that using Twitter has kind of failed me. And you know, this is no knock. They make a great product so far. I'm really happy with it. It's not like I'm going to return it or anything like that, but I really wish that they would have kind of like not, it felt like they ignored my tweet and paid attention to Lenny's tweet, and that was the end of it. So I don't know. Maybe it'll get back to me today. Maybe it'll reach out to me or do something. But I really feel like rather than just kind of like ignoring that guy who's having a problem and really concentrate and even retweet the guy that likes what you're saying, that's kind of short-sighted on a company's part, and they should really try to pay attention to what they can do better and how they can make customers happier. Because the happy customer, is already happy. What are you going to do? The guy who's having a lot of trouble, who knows a little bit about technology and is a little frustrated, I would want to reach out to that guy first and try to solve that problem, because the product is one thing, the customer service is what you're really, in my mind, buying in the end. That's why I buy a lot of Apple products. That's why, because I can go to the Apple store and there's Apple Care, and there's a lot of simple ways that you can exchange devices and do stuff like that. So, but going back to the actual product, I'm going to give it a few more tries, see how it goes, see how I can kind of read the delay and all that stuff, or I just work out longer and it would be fine. But it is an excellent way with the DigiFit iCardio app to sync with MyFitnessPal, sync with the iOS 8 health app, all that stuff. And I'm going to do a separate review on the actual app, on the iOS health app, how this integrates. And obviously the 6 Plus is a whole different review in itself. So just make sure you like the video, comment if you have any experience with this or any other heart rate monitor or fitness tracking device, because I'm getting a bunch of them and I'm going to start integrating that with DDP Yoga and my other fitness videos. So, but for now, for everybody here at the T4 Show, which is it's 5 o'clock in the morning, there's nobody here. Thank you. And best luck in all your future heart rate monitor endeavors. That's just like Hurricane Holmes, isn't it? Cool. Hey, Shane, what's up?